Good morning. My name is Ramesh HG, Assistant Professor of Mathematics, Government Postgraduate College, Tiptur. Today I am going to explain exact differential equation and reducible to exact differential equation. So there are mainly four rules. Rules to determine integrating factors. Now we shall see few rules to determine suitable integrating factors. So rule 1. Here we have to reduce the differential equation into exact differential equation by finding suitable integrating factor. So in this topic we have to reduce non-exact differential equation into exact differential equation by finding a suitable integrating factor. So to find a suitable integrating factor, we have four rules. So I explain one by one. So rule 1. If m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree, if m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree and mx plus ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by mx plus ny is an integrating factor for mdx plus ndy. That means if mdx plus ndy is given differential equation and which is not exact equation, that means dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, and m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree and mx plus ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by mx plus ny is an integrating factor. That means we have to multiply the given differential equation by 1 by mx plus ny, then the non-exact differential equation is converted into exact differential equation. So that is the rule 1. Okay. So rule 1 is, let mdx plus ndy is equal to 0 is a given differential equation and which is not exact differential equation. That means dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, then and m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree and mx plus ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by mx plus ny is an integrating factor for the given differential equation. That means you have to multiply the given differential equation by 1 by mx plus ny, that equation becomes exact differential equation. That is rule 1. So rule 2. Let mdx plus ndy is equal to 0 be the given differential equation and which is not exact differential equation. If 1 by n into dou m by dou y, 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is a function of x, say f of x, or a constant, then e to the power of integral of f of x dx or e to the power of integral of k into dx is an integrating factor for mdx plus ndy. Then you have to multiply by integrating factor. We reduce this into exact differential equation. That is a rule 2. That means that mdx plus ndy with the given differential equation, which is not exact equation, then 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is a function of x alone or a constant, then e to the power of integral of f of x into dx or e to the power of integral of k into dx is an integrating factor for mdx plus ndy. Then you have to multiply the given equation by 1 by e to the power of integral of f of x into dx. Then the equation reduces to exact differential equation. step 3. If 1 by m into dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y is a function of y alone, say g of y are a constant, then e to the power of integral of g of y into dy is an integrating factor for mdx plus ndy is equal to 0. That means you have to multiply the given equation by e to the power of integral of dy, then the equation reduces to exact differential equation. Rule 4. So if the equation is in the form of f1 of xy into y dx plus f2 of xy into x dy is equal to 0, with m as y into f1 of xy and n as x into f2 of xy and mx minus ny is not equal to 0, then 1 by mx minus ny is an integrating factor. Then we have to multiply the given equation by 1 by mx minus ny. That equation becomes the exact differential equation. So these are the main three rules. And one more rule is, One is, first one is 1 by mx plus ny, that is homogeneous functions. Next one is 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is a function of x. And next one is 1 by m into dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y. And next rule 4 is 1 by mx minus ny. We take one by one examples. Find the suitable integrating factor and solve the given differential equation. So let xy dx minus x square plus 2y square dy is equal to 0. So observe that this is in the form of mdx plus ndy. So clearly compare with this equation with mdx plus ndy. So m is xy and n is minus x square plus 2y square. So clearly dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x. Dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x. And hence it is not an exact differential equation. So then you apply the rules. So we may apply first rule. Here observe that m and n are homogeneous functions of degree 2. So xy, m is xy, it is degree 2. N is x square, 2y square, it is also degree 2. Therefore, m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree. Consider mx plus ny is equal to x square y minus x square y minus 2y cube is equal to minus 2y cube, that is not equal to 0. So, that is not equal to 0. Then, by rule 1, 1 by mx plus ny is equal to minus 1 by 2y cube. So, this is an integrating factor. So, here we find integrating factor. Next step is multiplying the equation by minus 1 by 2y cube. We get, so multiply both sides by minus 1 by 2y cube. So, this is minus x by 2y square dx plus x square by 2y cube plus 1 by y into dy is equal to 0. Here observe that this equation becomes exact differential equation. Here m value is minus x by 2y square, n value is x square by 2y cube plus 1 by y. So you may verify for exact equation dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Or this can also be solved by using a grouping of the terms. So this equation is exact. The equation can be written as 1 by y into dy, 1 by y into dy minus x by 2y square dx minus x square by 2y cube dy is equal to 0. This equation can be grouped as like this. Or 1 by y into dy can be written as derivative of log y minus Next two terms can be written as derivative of x square by 4y square is equal to 0. This can also be solved by using the formula integration of mdx plus terms of n not containing x into dy is equal to 0. Or by grouping, it can also be solved. So, on integrating, we get log y minus x square by 4y square is equal to c. This is the solution of the given differential equation. So, given equation, suppose if the given equation is not exact, then observe that the m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree. Then you find out mx plus ny, which is not equal to 0. Then 1 by mx plus ny is the integrative factor. Multiply the given equation by 1 by mx plus ny. And this becomes exact differential equation. Then you may solve in any one method, grouping method or bidirect solution method. Second problem, solve x square y dx minus x cube plus y cube into dy is equal to 0. So, you see that it is a non-exact equation. It is not an exact equation since dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x. So, it is not an exact equation. And you see that m and n are both are homogeneous functions of same degree. Homogeneous functions of same degree. So, m and n are both are homogeneous functions of degree 3. Both are homogeneous and are same degree. Then, mx plus ny is equal to x cube y minus yx cube minus y to the power of 4 is equal to minus y to the power of 4, which is not equal to 0. Then you apply rule 1, 1 by mx plus ny is equal to minus 1 by y to the power of 4, which is an integrating factor for the given differential equation. So, multiply the given equation by minus 1 by y to the power of 4. Then the equation becomes exact differential equation. So, we get, after multiplying the equation, minus x square by y cube dx plus x to the power of 3 by y to the power of 4 plus 1 by y into dy is equal to 0. Then consider integration of, this become my exact differential equation. Then different integration mdx is equal to x cube minus x cube by 3y cube and terms of n not containing x is 1 by y. So this is equal to log y. Thus the equation becomes log y minus x cube by 3y cube is equal to, see, this is the solution of the given differential equation. So after the differential equation become exact, we may solve in two methods. One is by grouping method, another one is by direct solution method. By directly you can calculate the solution. Example 3. Solve the equation y into 8x minus 9y into dx plus 2x into x minus 3y into dy is equal to 0. Here m is equal to y into 8x minus 9y and n is equal to 2x into x minus 3y. And observe that this equation is not exact equation. Dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x. So, dou m by dou y is equal to 8x minus 18y. And dou n by dou x is equal to 4x minus 6y. So, you may apply two rule 2. So, dou m by dou y minus 2n by dou x is equal to 8x minus 18y minus 4x plus 6y. That is equal to 4 into x minus 3y. 4 into x minus 3y. So, you apply rule 2. So, next 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x. This is equal to, so after simplification, it becomes 2 by x. So 2 by x. So which is a function of x, that is from rule 2. If the term 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x is a function of x, then e to the power of integral of 2 by x dx is the integrating factor, and this is equal to e to the power of log of x square, or e and log cancel, it is x square is the integrating factor. So once we get integrating factor, you multiply the given equation by x square, we get multiply the given equation by x square, we have 8x cube y minus 9y square x square dx plus 2x to the power of 4 minus 6x cube y into dy is equal to 0. This equation becomes exact. One can verify for exactness dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. The above equation can be regrouped as, so we may directly find the solution by using integration of m dx plus terms of n not containing x into dy is equal to 0, or by grouping method we can also find the solution. So the above equation can be regrouped as 8x cube y dx minus 2x to the power of 4 into dy minus 9y square x square dx plus 6x cube y into dy is equal to 0. So first two terms can be written as derivative of 2yx to the power of 4 minus next two terms can be written as derivative of 3y square x cube is equal to 0. On integration we get 2yx to the power of 4 minus 3y square x cube is equal to c, and this is the required solution of the given differential equation. So in this problem we apply second rule. So very important, second rule is dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, then you take the term as 1 by n into dou m by dou y minus dou n by dou x, and if this is a function of x, then e to the power of integral of f of x dx become the integrating factor for the given differential equation, and then multiply the equation by the integrating factor, the equation becomes exact differential equation, and then you may solve the differential equation. Example 4. Xy into sin xy plus cos of xy into y dx plus xy into sin xy minus cos xy into x dy is equal to 0. Solution. In this equation, so m and n are in the form of. So once observe that the differential equation is not an exact equation. So one may verify for exactness. So this is not an exact differential equation. If the given equation is exact, then you directly write to m and n and integration m dx plus terms of n not containing into x into dy is equal to c. So if it is not exact, then the problem. So what is the value of m is xy sin xy plus cos xy into y, and what is the value of n is xy sin xy minus cos xy into x. And you apply rule 4. Here you apply rule 4. 1 by mx minus ny, that is equal to 1 by 2xy into cos xy is an integrating factor. So this is an integrating factor. So multiply the equation by 1 by 2xy into cos xy. We have 1 by 2xy into cos xy into equation 1. Then the equation 1 becomes, then the equation 1 becomes y tan xy plus 1 by x into dx plus x tan xy minus 1 by y into dy is equal to 0. This is an exact equation of the form m dx plus n dy. So this is an exact differential equation, and it is in the form of m dx plus n dy. What are the values of m is here y tan xy plus 1 by x, and what is the value of n is x tan xy minus 1 by y. We may verify for exactness also. and the solution is given by integration of mdx, so that is equal to integration of y tan xy plus 1 by x into dx, which is equal to y into 1 by y log of secant of xy plus log x, or yy cancel, log of secant of xy plus log x. And second one is the terms of a not containing x into dy. This is equal to minus 1 by y into dy is equal to minus log y. And adding these two terms, we get log of secant of xy plus log x minus log y is equal to log c. So all our log terms on simplification, xy into secant of xy is equal to c, the solution of the given differential equation. Solution of the given differential equation. Example 5, fifth problem. Solve the equation. So solve 3x square y to the power of 4 plus 2xy into dx plus 2y cube x cube minus x square into dy is equal to 0. So here m is equal to 3x square y to the power of 4 plus 2xy, and n is equal to 2x cube y cube minus x square. So dou m by dou y is equal to 12x square y cube plus 2x, and dou n by dou x is equal to 6x square y cube minus 2x. So now 1 by m into dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y. So this is rule 3. 1 by m into dou n by dou x minus dou m by dou y. This is equal to minus 6x square y cube minus 4x divided by 3x square root to the power of 4 minus 2xy. So on simplifying, we get minus 2 by y, which is a function of y alone. So by rule 3, so minus 2 by y is a function of y alone. By rule 3, e to the power of integral of minus 2 by y dy is the integrating factor. On simplification, we get 1 by y square. So 1 by y square is the integrating factor for the given differential equation. And if you multiply the given equation by 1 by y square, we get 3x square y square plus 2x 1 by y into dx plus 2x cube y minus x square by y square dy is equal to 0. So this equation becomes exact differential equation. So we may verify for exactness dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x, or we may write the solution as integration of mdx plus in terms of n not containing x into dy is equal to c, or rearrange the terms, we get 3x square y square dx plus 2x cube y dy plus 2x by y dx minus x square y square by y square dy is equal to 0. Or first two terms can be written as derivative of x cube y square plus derivative of x square by y is equal to 0. On integrating x cube y square plus x square y is equal to c, or x cube y cube plus x square is equal to cy. This is the required solution of the given differential equation. So in this way, we apply rule 1, rule 2, rule 3 required by the problem and solve the differential equation. Next problem is x square y dx minus x cube plus y cube into dy is equal to 0. Given m is equal to x square y and n is equal to minus x cube minus y cube. Here you see that dou m by dou y is equal to x square, dou n by dou x equal to minus 3x square. Therefore, dou m by dou y is not equal to dou n by dou x, and hence 1 is not exact differential equation. So we may find the integrating factor. For this, you may apply rule 1, because m and n are homogeneous functions of same degree. consider 1 by mx plus ny. This is equal to 1 by x cube y minus x cube y minus y to the power of 4. This is equal to minus 1 by y to the power of 4. Our integrating factor is equal to minus 1 by y to the power of 4. So this is the integrating factor for the given differential equation. Multiply by minus 1 by y to the power of 4, the equation 1, we get minus x square by y cube dx plus x cube by y to the power of 4 plus 1 by y into dy is equal to 0. Then you get m is equal to minus x square by y cube and n is x cube by y cube plus 1 by y. Dou m by dou y is equal to 3x square by y to the power of 4 and dou n by dou x is 3x square by y to the power of 4. So this is an exact differential equation. And the solution is given by integration of m dx is equal to integration of minus x square by y cube, that is equal to minus x cube by 3y cube, and integration of terms of n not containing x, that is 1 by y dy is equal to log y. The solution is minus x cube by 3y cube plus log y is equal to c. So in this way you can find integrating factors by using the rule 1, rule 2, rule 3 and rule 4, and hence reduce the given differential equation into exact differential equation, and then solve the exact differential equation by any one of the rule, that is grouping the terms, or by direct write the solution of the differential equation. So these are some methods of finding reducing the non-exact equation into exact differential equation. Thank you.